हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9 डीवी मॉडल पब्लिक स्कूल वेलकम्स यू ऑल इन ई लर्निंग क्लास। दिस इज योर सोशल साइंस टीचर नितिन पुष्पदुड़े। टुडेज टॉपिक इज पीपल एज रिसोर्स। अंडर दिस टॉपिक टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर टुडेज ऑनलाइन सेशन। स्टूडेंट्स, ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेस, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेस? लिसन, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स इज द सेट ऑफ द पीपल हु मेक अप द वर्क फोर्स ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, बिजनेस सेक्टर, इंडस्ट्री और इकोनॉमी। इट्स कॉल्ड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स। इट हैज टू मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर्स, एसेट एंड लाइबिलिटी। फर्स्ट, एसेट, अ पर्सन और थिंग दैट इज यूज पुट टू समथिंग और समबडी। इट्स कॉल्ड एसेट। अनदर, लाइबिलिटी, द स्टेट ऑफ बींग रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर समथिंग। दैट मीन्स अ लाइबिलिटी इज समथिंग अ पर्सन और कंपनी ओज, यूजली अ सम ऑफ मनी। इट्स कॉल्ड लाइबिलिटी। लाइबिलिटी इंक्लूड्स लोन, अकाउंट पेबल, बॉन्ड्स, वारंटीज एटसेट्रा। सो इट्स अ लाइबिलिटी। स्टूडेंट्स, पॉपुलेशन इज एन एसेट फॉर द इकोनॉमी रैदर दैन अ लाइबिलिटी। इट बिकम्स ह्यूमन कैपिटल व्हेन इन्वेस्टमेंट्स आर मेड इन इट्स हेल्थ केयर, ट्रेनिंग एंड एजुकेशन। लैंड एंड कैपिटल आर मेड यूजफुल बाय ह्यूमन कैपिटल। That's why human capital is superior to other forms of capital. Students, working population of a country, the existing productive skills and abilities are known as people as resource. This productive nature of the population helps to develop the gross national product, that means GNP of a country, through its abilities. So it's also known as human resources. Okay. Students, next point, classification of activities in a various sectors. Students, all activities are classified into the three sectors, primary, secondary and tertiary. First, primary sector. Listen students, all activities which harvest or extract natural product from the earth or natural resources are classified in this category. Okay students, that means agriculture, forestry, dairy farming, animal husbandry, fisheries, poultry farming and mining, that all activities are included in a primary sector. That means these are the examples of primary activities. Listen students, second one, secondary sector. Okay, using products resulting from activities in the primary sector for manufacturing of finishing goods are classified in this category. All manufacturing processes and construction activities are included in the secondary sector. For example, manufacturing process from cotton to cloth, that means cotton is a raw material is using in a textile industry. So this activity is called the secondary sector activity. Okay, third one students, tertiary sector. All activities which support a primary and secondary sectors are classified in this category. These include trade, transportation, communication, sales and service, education, health, tourism, banking, insurance, legal services. Okay, these are called the tertiary sector activity. In the given picture you are seeing, okay, that all services are called the tertiary sector activities. Students, next one, types of economic activities. Students, activities which add value to the national income are called economic activities or market activities. Listen students, first, market activities means what? These activities involve remuneration to the person who performs an activity for pay or profit. For example, production of goods or service including government services. Okay, so it's called the market activity. Again students, non-market activity, another is what? Non-market activity. These activities are not paid, or production of these activities is for self-consumption or self-use. Okay, for example, women doing the domestic work, again looking after children, are non-market activities. Students, while men working in the fields, again they spend on rearing their families, are the market activities. Okay, so these are the market activities. Students, next topic is quality population. Okay, Quality of a population is the overall qualitative functioning of the population that signifies its social, economic and cultural growth and output. Education and health are the most important factors affecting quality of population. Students, education, yes, education opens new horizons and develops life values and gives rise to a new aspirations. It increases the national income as well as the cultural richness and efficiency of governance. Vocational education has been developed to provide skills, to provide the skills-based education which leads to ready employment. Okay, students, just I am telling you the education scenario in India. Listen, there is a provision made for the providing universal access, retention and quality in elementary education with a special emphasis on girls. Special schools called Navodaya Vidyalaya have been established in each district. Students, government expenditure on education has increased in the last few years. There are still many disparities in literacy. Female literacy remains much lower than the male literacy all over India. Students, there is a wide variation in literacy rates from one region to another. For example, there is about 94% literacy in Kerala, but 62% in Bihar. Students, government has taken many steps towards providing elementary education to all. Some important steps are like, listen, the primary school system has expanded. Again, government initiative of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan aims at providing elementary education to all the children in the age of 6 to 14 year group. Okay. Again, students, midday meal scheme has been implemented to encourage attendance and retention of school children and improve their nutritional status. Again, students, 10th 5-year plan. Now, students, still 2020, near about 16, how many? 16 10th 5-year plan have been taken by the government for the all-round development of country. Okay, students, next one is what? Health. Listen, students, proper health care helps a person to realize his potential and ability to fight illness. Listen, students, proper health care helps a person to realize his potential and ability to fight illness. So the government of national policy on health aims at improving the access to health care, family welfare and nutritional service. During the last 50 years, India has built up a vast healthcare, manpower and infrastructure. Students, what are the advantages of this health infrastructure? Listen, some results we are seeing that. First, life expectancy has increased. Again, infant mortality rate has come down. Then again, crude birth rate has dropped. Okay. Students, do you know about the, so these are the advantages of healthcare of our country. Students, about sex ratio, you know, yes, what is the sex ratio according to 2001 census? How many? Listen, students, 928 female per 1000 males. This is the sex ratio of 2001 census. Students, according to 2011, the sex ratio is what? 943 female per 1000 males. Okay, students, in such a way that today we will learn about the quality of education, then again the activities, okay, and again the healthcare, health infrastructure. Okay, students, on the basis of today's content, some assignment question I am giving you. There are the three questions in front of you. You have to write the answer of this question, students. Remaining part of this lesson we will learn in the next online session. Okay, students, thank you very much and have a nice day.